you are watching this, you've been playing games for most of your life, and any person who's ever played a video game has had the thought that they could make something better. This has led to a large economy around teaching game development. You can look through YouTube, there's an enormous amount of tutorials telling people how to make their very first game. With just a little bit of Googling, most of us stumble upon Unity. This is the mainstay first choice game engine for beginners and advanced users alike. I personally, as a full-time Unity developer, have been using it for more than half a decade. But you are making a huge mistake in following Unity tutorials. And I will help you escape tutorial hell and reach a point where you are able to create something truly original. Tutorial hell is a state of mind or a situation you place yourself in. You don't actively learn. You are simply copying whatever you find on YouTube without understanding or even trying to understand what you are creating and why. And this mindset is dangerous because tutorials are rarely perfect. They're rarely even good. I was stuck in tutorial hell for a long time. I know at least the pathway I took to resolve this issue. This is not to be generalized, but for beginners, pretty shortly after you start learning Unity, you should start straying away from tutorials. They are bad for you and will install bad habits from just copying tutorials. I had been trying to use Unity since I was 12, 13. The best thing I could come up with was following tutorials online. This rarely led to anything good. I would usually just copy code until the tutorial series inevitably ended. So I would fail or give up halfway through if it got too hard. Since people rarely want to sit through a 1 hour tutorial explaining how to make the most optimal health system, YouTube videos are therefore favoring speed over quality. Even if the person making the tutorial is skilled, he has to make the video digestible to an audience, and that makes it incredibly difficult for him to make code of high quality, which 99% of the audience doesn't care about. They just want their health system. Most of these tutorials will instill bad coding habits. They will make you write useless variable names. They will cause you to put everything into a single class. They will break the well-established coding conventions that have been used for decades at this point. And once you begin to follow YouTube tutorials and you start following a series, from my experience, it primes you to rely on tutorials when you don't understand something. Instead of actually trying to solve the issue, you try and look up the answer for the issue. This makes it hard to actually be able to think for yourself, because in the back of your mind, you already know that the solution exists. It's a few keystrokes away on Google somewhere. There's some guy who's made a tutorial that explains exactly what you want to make, and you can have it done in 5 minutes. But in the long run, this will only limit you, even though for the moment it feels nice to make progress on your current project. What's most common and most dangerous is it creates a false sense of learning. You feel as if you're making progress because, see, I have a bunch of projects done. I made this game and that game. Yeah, sure, you put code into an editor, but did you make them? Because 10,000 other people have said the same thing, and you have the same product at the end. Did you create something or did you copy something? However, of course, there are benefits to tutorials. They are sometimes helpful and good. If I'm trying to learn a completely new concept in a game engine, if I'm trying to learn a completely new language, I'll look up a few tutorial series and see the general workflow. But what I never do is I never copy anything. I never copy any code. I never do any of that. Tutorials are the starting line to becoming a game developer. As soon as you take 5 steps ahead, you should quit almost entirely. There are so many other good sources that will teach you, or they will force you to learn instead of just blindly copying. For a beginner, the goal might be to start with a tutorial, maybe buy a course on Udemy. But as soon as you've done one, don't buy another one immediately. See what you've acquired as an actual skill. Because if you've worked and used this tutorial the standard way that most people do, I bet that you won't be able to recreate whatever you just made without having to reference the tutorial again. You're gonna have a hard time at least. So did you really learn, or was it just copying? There are benefits to using tutorials. A method I like to use is I follow a tutorial, I copy everything down, like most of you do, but I changed the name of every variable and class throughout the whole project, because this requires me to keep a mental map of the class in my mind to keep track of. This will require that I actually pay attention to where code is placed, what variables are used, and why they are used. If you want to continue using tutorials for a little while longer, do that. Rename everything, change the coding structure, write it in your own style, and try and modify it as much as possible, but keep the core logic from the tutorial. This will force you to learn. The real solution and what you should be doing instead within the first month of learning programming and game development is to learn programming fundamentals for object-oriented programming languages like C++, C#. Even if you don't want to focus on that part of game development, if you want to make games at all, or you want to become an indie developer, some level of programming skills are going to be required. And there are a bunch of good articles, books, YouTube lectures. You can find the CS50 course from Harvard. They have their whole introduction course to computer science available online for free. This will give you the building blocks to then expand and learn the Unity-specific functionalities that aren't really transferable to other game engines. If you can learn the programming fundamentals for object-oriented programming, you can switch to Unreal Engine or Godot. It will take a few weeks to get used to the engine-specific things, but you get over that really quickly. And if you continue to work in Unity, as I actually recommend you do, instead of immediately going to YouTube, begin searching through the C# or Unity documentation. They have very well documented and show code examples of how you can use the Unity-specific components and classes to make games. So if you want to know how to use a raycast, instead of going to YouTube and Googling how to use Unity raycasts, go to the Unity documentation, search raycast, and they have some very nice examples for 2D raycasts and normal raycasts, and you can kind of infer how to use them from the code examples. And that will force you to think ahead and absorb the information a bit. And of course, I don't expect you to learn everything on your first try, but you will learn a lot quicker by going and having to read it in the documentation and have a good formal explanation from Unity than just going to a YouTube tutorial and copying whatever you find. You need to become a professional Googler. Google is widely used and expected of you to use because Stack Overflow exists, where you can get some very code-heavy questions answered. Questions from the year 2002 are still relevant because the core principles are the same. Object-oriented programming languages haven't changed, the software using them have. So look at more recent stuff with Unity, follow their documentation. But if it's a general programming question, just Google it and you'll find a Stack Overflow answer. And it's most often quite thorough, and sometimes they have a good explanation. I know you're eager to make video games, but you have to be careful because the path you choose right now at the start of your journey, you've just downloaded Unity. This is going to determine whether you give up in a month or if you stick with it and become a full-time game dev in the future. Use tutorials in the beginning, sparingly. As soon as you feel slightly comfortable with Unity, just the interface, just switch over and start studying object-oriented programming principles. Buy a C# book and begin to study that. As soon as you have the fundamentals done, everything else feels much faster and everything's gonna speed up by 100-fold. And you're gonna notice the difference. If you want to learn a bit more why I think you should avoid using Unity in the beginning and focus on the coding fundamentals, check out my video on the topic where I explain my thought process. So, like if you liked, otherwise, bye.